So yesterday's video got me thinking a little bit about some crazy CC lures we've seen in the past.
What is going on here? What is he doing with this golem?
I'll talk more about those a little bit later on this episode. Yo, what's up, guys? It's Powerbang, and welcome back to another Clash of Clans video. We're gonna hop straight into the action today. This was the content that I promised you from this weekend's CWL matchup. Week 1, WHF taking on Cold September. We're gonna get right into the Town Hall 11 versus Town Hall 11 action. Looking at Sir Longsword here, cleaning up that amazing 80% scout done on this base by a Town Hall 10. So one thing I want to focus on in this video is the Town Hall 11 play specifically. We started out with two Town Hall 11 hits and three-starred them both using the same exact attack strategy. And that is basically a queen walk going into a queen charge, but grouping up with a bowler kill squad here. And that is kind of exactly what's going on here with Sir Longsword, except for he's going to be bringing giants out of the clan castle as well as a P.E.K.K.A. with that group, using the P.E.K.K.A. to just clear around, actually be a little bit of a tanky body. Thank you, Ash, for the notifications, man. I will be sure to check out your video later. You guys should all do that too. My buddy Ash, he's got a channel. You might know him. Anyways, wait till my video's done, then go watch his. Anyways, guys, into the core, the queen goes. Bowler's in there taking out that eagle. And once that eagle is out, this base is inevitably wrecked. But at the same time, it's all about the queen and keeping her alive. Having all of these bowlers out in front makes it so the Inferno Tower goes down before it ever locks onto a queen. And that is kind of what you're hoping for. You see the healers lagging behind, keeping that queen up to full health pretty much. And she's just going to push her way through. Bowler's still alive on the left side. The king over there as well, pushing all the way through that backside. He's used his ability. But other than that, this base is, it's pretty much falling down at the moment. It is going to be a little bit close. He's got to, have that queen stay out of harm's way of the Inferno Tower. But he does have an ability left. And that queen ability pretty much guarantees his safety. Misses a little bit on the rage here. I'm not sure what that rage was, but it doesn't really matter. Queen takes out the air defense. Now we know the healers are going to survive. And Sir Longsword's going to pop the ability on that Inferno Tower. And then just targets the wall, which is beautiful. And that's going to get him that last couple of buildings, including the Archer Tower, for the 3-stars. So beautiful job to Sir Longsword. We got another Town Hall 11 attack. Hitting another Town Hall 11, and that is going to be another 3-star using the same particular strategy. And this is going to be Nick taking on Hammer Time from Cold September. He starts off with the queen charge over on the left side of this base. Notice how he drops the funneling troops in to make sure the queen goes the right direction. She steps in. She's going to get an archer tower here and ultimately going to walk up the wall here to the northern part of the base, where that's where the kill squad is supposed to meet up with her. So the baby dragon getting a ton of value here, going down the outside of this base. We've got rage spells, a couple of jumps in this one. Now the jumps are, in bases where your wall breakers are going to have some difficulties. Like in this one, he didn't want to try to get through that wizard tower up top, the bomb tower that's up there. The queen potentially could, reach out and shoot something. He just said, you know what, I'm going to drop the jump spell. And, we're going to move this army in through the top of the base. You can see some bowlers and witches on the corner, just like a bow witch attack, where they are going to go down the side of the base and basically keep everything out of play, destroy it all. That is the plan. Wizard Tower outside is actually going to be a little bit difficult for those skellies, but it's not going to matter. Notice in the interior, the Inferno Tower locks onto the king, but inside that Grand Warden ability, it is not able to do any damage, and the Inferno Tower does go down to the bowlers before the king takes any damage at all. So beautifully done on that. It looks like the queen, king, warden, all of them heading around the outside of the base at this point. You see the wizards and witches and bowlers up top going around the outside of this base, making sure it's clear. But in the inner ring, again, it comes down to the queen. Queen having that set of healers on her, and again, only one air defense left in this one. It almost got taken out as well. But when you've only got a few buildings left and you do have healers still alive to keep that queen going, that is oftentimes all you need. Nick here with the great timing on the wizard on the bottom of this base, dropping it as the queen picks up aggro from that archer tower and mortar. Wizard able to get in close enough to the mortar to take it out before the queen gets out of range. Really nice job on the attack. So Nick and Sir Longsword both picking up Town Hall 11 3-stars in this particular war. Beautiful job on the attacks, gentlemen, and I cannot wait to see the Town Hall 10 stuff that we're going to throw in here for a bonus. Let's go ahead and queue up another attack. Now we've got Ossitron. If you guys remember to yesterday's video, thank you so much for the response, the likes on the video. That was amazing. The intro. I don't know if you guys remember the intro. Wait. Why isn't he firing? You guys remember that CC kill? Well, I'm not going to name who that was. I can tell you who it was not, though. It was not Ossitron. He's already had his moment of fame, his time in the sun from his CC kill probably 2 years ago now when he ping-ponged the golem back and forth across the base. It was one of the funniest things I've ever had the pleasure of watching live.
What the f*** is going on here? What is he doing with this golem? What is he doing with this golem? Oh my god. So he's gonna get killed anyway by it. All of his Valks died.
I do think yesterday's CC kill topped that one, though. I will include a link to that video in the description below. Definitely go watch it because, oh my god, it was the funniest CC lure I have ever seen up until possibly yesterday. That being said, though, Ossitron on this one, beautiful wall break here. He actually is going to rage in his wall breakers because for some reason he dropped 4 wall breakers, and of course they went 2 and 2, and they split. And he had to rage him up to get through the wall. But it ultimately was a great decision. Uses the queen ability, clears out that whole first section. Now he's got that beautiful pathing around the base. Looks like the lava hounds and the loons are going to be, just taking this thing apart, dissecting it. I love how he used the loons to perfectly avoid these air sweepers. They did hit his balloons, but they were more focused on his hounds. And look at how those balloons just narrowly missed it. They get into the rage. Sneak up behind those air sweepers, take them out. Awesome stuff here. Haste Spell leads everything into the Inferno Tower. Single target locked onto a loon rather than the hound, so the hound's gonna sit on the bottom on the final air defense, tank everything. Heal Spell gets it all back up to full health, and would you look at that? One hound still alive to tank, and it looks like the loons are gonna take the final few buildings out here for the 3-star. 2 Teslas alive on the outside. And that is going to, as I die here choking on my own saliva, looks like the Teslas are going to go down, and the loons pick up the 3-star here, going to be cleaning everything up. Ossitron getting it done. Man, there was a lot of references, I will say, to that old raid. Ozzy is never going to live that one down. That was the first thing that was said in Discord, actually, was, yo, dude, this was worse than mine. So, anyways, next up, we've got Lexnos. Lexnos dropping another 6-pack in our war against Cold September. In all fairness, though, he cleaned up one of his own fails on Lexnos. So, you know, it wasn't quite perfection, but, still pretty dang good, dude. So, here we go. Lexnos going in. And in this raid, guys, he's bringing the Hog Riders. So, he starts off on the bottom with the Queen. And there's that king on the outside of this base. You know how he likes to drop the king near the queen to do that funneling. And then he's going to drop in some wall breakers here to avoid really any fire. They open up the wall beautifully. And that's going to let the queen get in there to target the expo, the cannon, possibly even reach the enemy queen here. We'll have to see if she's able to get in close enough to make that happen. There is the CC, though. It comes out. We've got witches. We've got baby dragon. That caused our boys yesterday some problems, but today, Lexnos is going to take care of it, no problem. This is how you do it, though, boys. You drop the poison on the CC so they don't have a chance to swerve out of the way. Lexnos getting it done, continuing the walk. Here are some more wall breakers coming in from deep. He rages them up to make sure they get through the wall, and they do, in fact, get through the wall. So here is the queen. She's going to make a right-hand turn into the core now, and this is where she's going to pick up that queen. It's a beautiful charge, actually, because so much value here. Cleans out half of the base. He also gets the CC. He's going to get the queen herself, so a lot of objectives taken care of here. She doesn't have any more rages, though, so the charge will get cut short if he does not pop this ability here pretty quickly. There it is. Queen comes out to engage, pops the ability. She's going to get taken out. And continue on with the walk. So really nice job. Here comes the Hog Riders. A few to the core, a few few to the Inferno Tower, and a few on the outside edge here. And just watch the heal spell placements in this raid, guys. They perfectly encompass all of those Hog Riders on the first one and on the second one as well as they all kind of go in. Look at the outside Hogs right now being kept up by that single heal spell, and the ones on the interior are as well. So they head into the final quadrant here. All Infernos are down, and again, beautiful heal spell placement. The Queen, look at her. She's still hanging on by a thread. Archer Tower locks onto her, but it's not enough. She is going to survive. Takes out the final Tesla, and the Hog Riders are doing their thing, taking out the cannon, one more Tesla, and a mortar, and that is that. So beautifully done by Lexnos, again, with the six-pack. So tip of the cap to you, sir. Nice work on the attacks. Lexnos get it done. Lexnos didn't, though. I gotta point that out. Next war, maybe a 12-pack, sir. Maybe a 12-pack. All right, next up, we got Jeeper 5150, and this is going to be our final raid of the video. Guys, he's going to be bringing a beautiful combination here on this Tesla. This base has been scouted, so he knew that there was a giant bomb there, and look at that. He triggers it with a single wall breaker. So beautiful efficiency on that. It's going to prevent his Hog Riders from running over that in just a moment here. You guys will have to wait and see. So here we go. In the Golem goes, we've got the bowlers. We got a couple of wizards here doing some funneling and a perfect wall break on that cannon. Once the first compartment was cleared out of a building, the wall breakers were going to target the second one. It was just awesome work there on that entry. Subtle little differences like that really make the raid. And as you can see, the jump spell placed down before the outer compartment buildings are taken out. That way, the King and the Queen progress into the base. Here's that Rage Spell to receive them, and they are going to get a huge push here through the CC, through the Queen, through the left compartment. Bowler's still doing work, and that Queen, keep an eye on her throughout this raid, guys. She is going to get all the way back to the Inferno Tower. But let's watch the Hogs. That first group avoids the giant bomb that was already pre-triggered, so that's beautifully done. And then into the backside they go. Look at this heal spell getting all of the Hogs healed back up. And it does look like he's dragging some skellies along with him here. You're going to see a poison spell come down in just a moment. And it is going to take out those skellies. Perfect job on the raid. Jeeper gets a heal spell down to heal everything up, going into the final quadrant. And notice the Queen has taken out the Inferno, so she does not even leave that up to deal with like the Hogs at all. So the Hogs go straight to the last defense, get the Archer Tower taken out, turn, smack the skellies down, and that is that. So this was just an awesome war all the way around. Can't say how proud enough I am of my guys. You guys were amazing. 130 to 126 was your final in this 45 versus 45 person affair. I would have brought more replays, guys, but unfortunately, you're gonna see it right here in the outro. We kind of ran out of time. Let's go check the next one. Oh, replay no longer available. So that's gonna do it for today's episode, guys. Like the video if you did, and subscribe to the channel if you're new here. That's all I got, though. I'll see you guys in the next one.